All right, guys, as promised, I'm gonna film us attempting to pull the door out on the Cutlass. I have no idea how well this is gonna work. The only other time I've ever tried to pull a door out was way back in the day with my full-size green Lincoln. And when we did that, we did very similar to what we have here. We had a chain wrapped around the door on the inside and we yanked it out. What we found out with the problem with doing it that way is, when you pull the top part of the chain and the bottom part of that chain squeezed together and actually pinched my door down and up at the same time and crushed it as we pulled it out. So what we did different this time, after learning from way long ago, I have a big piece of square tubing in here that my chain runs through. And that is to distribute the surface area on this door so the chain cannot suck down any tighter than the length of this tube. So when we pull, hopefully we're gonna pull at an equal amount of strength the entire length of the tubing and pull this door out. I don't know if it's gonna work, but we're gonna try it. We have it hooked up to the ugly duckling, which is currently sitting here running, or trying to stay running. It's pretty low on gas, so it may die on us. It's due for some fresh gas. That thing probably has 2-year-old gas sitting in it right now. And with the very small amount that's left, it expires a lot quicker. So I will probably put fresh gas in it sometime this weekend when I get a chance. Fuel stabilizer, whatever, get it ready for winter. So we're gonna give it a tug. It may actually break my aftermarket custom bumper bracket on this thing because I don't really have that big of a tow hook on it. This is just made for pulling cars around the yard. It wasn't made to yank outdoors. But we're gonna see, it may snap that right off. We will find out on our first try. So Susan's gonna be over here taking care of the camera, and go ahead and stand where you want. Hopefully the chain don't fly anywhere.
I mean, it moved the first time, but the second time it doesn't look like it's moved any. Quit. Stop. It's not broken. No, yeah, the whole thing back here.
It tore it out of the car. Well, that didn't last as long as I had hoped.
It out once, but then
yeah, it bent it a little. We need something stronger to yank on than this car. It moved it a little, not as much as I'd hoped. If we can't get it to yank out with a chain, we're gonna have to try a bottle jack or something else on that. I'm not sure, but so much for the back bumper. That thing was barely held on anyways. I'm just gonna rip this bumper the rest of the way off while it's still chained up. Get it tore off of here and just rip the whole bottom pan of the core out of this car out with it. Oh well. Let me just yank this bumper off and then we're gonna come up with a better idea of what to do. Hop in here. See if we can rip the rest of that bumper all the way off. There it went. Yep. Well, bumper removal. We got this top part to come out. It's about even now up here. Unfortunately, the bottom part's the main issue we get a worry about. But okay, let's come up with another idea and try attacking this again.
All right, guys, this is our second attempt of trying to pull this passenger door out. We're gonna attempt to use the bus this time. Let's see if we have any luck. Stop. Stop.
Tell me when to stop. Come back up to it. It's starting to go a little bit.
Yeah, I'll try it a couple more times. And
try again. Okay.
That
looked like it worked a lot better.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, look in here. I mean, it's a little bit in, but definitely not as bad as it was. That should give us enough room to get a cage in here. All right, let's unhook it and let's fire up the water. We'll go to work.